Yeah, I guess Coach is gonna be on time, you know. Timeliness is everything. I hope he's gonna be here. Just waiting. Oh, there's Coach. Hey, Coach, come on in. Come on in.
Chief, how are you?
Coach, good, good. Good afternoon, Coach.
Good seeing you. Good afternoon to you.
Right on time, as always.
Have to be, right?
Yeah, that's right.
Got to be on time. It's disrespectful to waste other people's time, so I'm never late.
Wow. That's a big deal. That's very important.
It really is.
Cannot waste people's time.
Our players and coaches, if they're late to a meeting, we close the door and they miss the meeting. And we're trying to teach lifelong lessons to these young people.
Wow.
That's our job.
Doing a great job. Welcome back, Coach. Great season.
Thank you,
sir. Good to see you.
Good to be back.
Yep. And I'm having our first all-staff department meeting in 20 years for the UNC Police Department.
Oh, my God.
You know, I know you have lots of experience in dealing with leadership and change and teamwork. And just tell me what your thoughts are about teamwork and organizational change.
Well, Chief, first, I think staff meetings are the most important thing. We have a team meeting before we ever practice.
Mm-hmm.
We have staff meetings every day.
Wow.
And we talk about who we are every day. I think the police business is not complicated. Football's not complicated. People are complicated.
Mm-hmm.
And everybody's got to be on the same page.
You're right.
So that's what staff meetings are for. They get everybody on the same page.
Mm-hmm.
And what we start with is communication. If you're new, you came in, a lot of these folks have been around here, it's like me. A lot of our staff's been here for a long time. They're looking at me like, he doesn't really know the place.
Mm-hmm.
And he doesn't get it, and that won't work here.
Right,
and
right.
So what we did is learn to communicate. We've all got to talk. If you have an opinion, it's a discussion. It's okay. I don't mind you having your opinion. Your opinion helps me be more creative. Maybe it gives me more information, and even if it doesn't, it lets me know how my staff feels.
That's great.
Because I need to know how you feel, even if I disagree with you.
And I can take that information and balance it against what I think is a priority, and then,
you make your decision. Then when you can communicate, you build up trust and respect.
Wow.
And without trust, you got nothing.
Gotta have it.
And if you give me your opinion, even if I'm not in agreement, I won't listen to it. And I'm going to look really, really hard at why that's your opinion. Because I trust you and I respect you.
That's powerful, Coach.
And then lastly, I went to Iraq and I stayed 10 days in 08 when we were fighting. And,
mm-hmm.
and
mm-hmm.
I was on the front lines and had 45 pounds of armor and...
Wow.
And I went to say thank you to our troops, but I learned more than I gave them. I sat down with General Odenaro, who was in charge of our troops in Iraq at that time, and I said, why do these young people stay over here at 19 years old and their average salary is $24,000 a year and they've got kids at home and families? Then they reenlist at Texas on the field or North Carolina on the field.
Mm-hmm.
They reenlist over here and they never go home. Mm-hmm. Why? And he said, we have a common purpose. And our common purpose is to bond with each other and protect America.
Mm.
And when I thought, that's what we have in football. That's what you've got in the police department. You're
mm-hmm.
protecting the campus.
That's right.
You're making it safe for people. You're taking care of us.
That's great.
But we talk about who you're going to vote for in the election.
Mm-hmm.
We talk about race. We talk about football. We talk about changing rules, transfer rules. You want to be in a portal? Come on.
Wow.
I got you a number here.
I got 2 years
of
eligibility left.
Well, I could put you in
a quarterback here.
But our team meetings and our player meetings are very important. It's important that we're organized. It's important that we're brief. And it's important that we're factual. I don't want them to feel like we're wasting any of their time. But I want them to know exactly how I feel about every issue.
I agree.
And if there's an elephant in the room, we're going to answer it now.
Just get it out.
And we get it out. And if you don't like it, if you're sensitive, this isn't the place to be.
How you feel about law enforcement, but specifically, how do you feel about your UNC Police Department?
I love it. Been great to me. Mm-hmm. Everywhere I go, I thank our police. I say thank you for keeping us safe. And I tell our kids, they're on your side. If you're doing things right, they're an ally. If you're not, but our police force does a tremendous job, and we put a lot of pressure on our campus because of football games.
Yeah,
we bring in 55,000 to 60,000 people that normally aren't here that are excited and having fun and sometimes indulging in activities that might not be the best for all of us.
A little adult beverage.
A little adult beverage.
But just tell them. Tell them how you do them. Thank you and what you feel.
Yeah. Thank you for your service. Thank you for your work. Your work's dangerous. Your work's hard because you're dealing with people that aren't usually at a good place in their life when you show up. and you don't get paid a whole lot. So we could not have our society like it is, safe in a free country, without you and our military. I thank you very much.
Thank you, Coach. I appreciate that. There's one last little thing. You know, I've been in the locker room a few times, and I see some moves or something that goes on in there. So
it is something. I'm not sure. Let's
see if we can go from there. You heard this song before?
I have.
You heard that? Heard that in the locker room?
Without question.
It's a beat.
I got the horses in the back. Horse stock is attached.
Go, Coach.
That is mad at black.
Yes. Don't do that. Don't forget the dip. You got to dip with it. Oh, there it is. The hands together.